Good evening, everyone. I am so honored to be serving as your mayor and to speak to you today about the state of our city. Live and in person. It's hard to believe that in 2019, when I last gave my State of the City presentation in person, Zoom was in my vocabulary only to describe the sounds of Vandenberg launches and the rate at which our tax return refund got spent. You can ask my husband that. I don't know where he is, but I think he's here somewhere. Today, I'm proud to stand here and say that despite some challenging years, the state of our city continues to be very strong. When I say that the state of our city is strong, that's not just because of what we've been able to accomplish this past year or even in 20 years that have whooshed by since Goleta became a city. We are also strong because we are poised to meet the challenges of the next 20 years and beyond, to ensure that the good land remains a special place we are all proud to call home. I'll be able to touch on only a few highlights of last year's accomplishments, and then I am excited to talk about just three examples that demonstrate our plans and actions for an even stronger future. But first, I want to thank my fellow city council members, Mayor Pro Tem Stuart Kasdan, Roger Aceves, James Carriaco, and Kyle Richards. While we may all come from different backgrounds and perspectives, one thing we do have in common, we all care deeply about Goleta and making thoughtful decisions to ensure Goleta's bright future. As American author John C. Maxwell said, teamwork makes the dream work. I also want to thank our hardworking and creative staff who are committed to making this city shine. They have been led by our seasoned city manager, Michelle Green, who will be leaving us in June when she and her family relocate to Vermont. We have been fortunate to have her calm demeanor for the past and experience to get us through the challenges of the past 2 years, as well as her counsel and leadership during 18 years with the city, including 8 years as our city manager. We will all have more time, opportunities to thank Michelle as her departure nears, but let's just say this, we have some big shoes to fill. Thanks are also due to our many board and commission members who so generously give us their talents and time to serve our community, and to all our residents who are engaged and participating in the ongoing public process we call local government. It's hard to imagine all that we've been through with the pandemic. In 2020, we had to cancel our State of the City event, and in 2021, we held it virtually, which is why we're so excited. If you can feel our excitement, we're so excited to be back in person today. We're also thrilled to finally welcome our community back to City Hall and Council Chambers for in-person meetings again, but we'll continue to encourage participation via Zoom for the foreseeable future. Now on to some of this past year's accomplishments. I'll begin by saying that we did not let the pandemic stop us. Our public works maintenance crew provided on-call, uninterrupted service to the community throughout the pandemic to deal with potholes and other hazards that cropped up. Our Goleta and San Ynez Valley Library staff have transitioned back and forth between offering sidewalk service to in-person service as public health guidelines changed and are preparing to debut a new catalog system and website this year. We can be especially proud of how our city responded with COVID relief efforts, including emergency rental assistance and individual grants, shelter and rapid housing programs, meals for seniors, childcare and scholarships, and small business loans and grants to support our locally owned businesses. Our CERT team went door to door providing information on changing restrictions and guidelines. We partnered with public health to distribute more than 10,000 COVID-19 test kits to the community. And to support our local businesses, we launched our goodlandgoodshopping.com website, a local digital gift card marketplace. We are pleased that our year-long process to create four city council districts was successfully completed. Voters in each district will elect a city council member who lives in their district, starting this fall in Goleta's two eastern districts. The mayor will continue to be elected by voters across all Goleta starting in 2024, when Goleta's two western district seats will be up for election. We made great strides in upgrading our parks and recreational opportunities. Four of our local parks have been upgraded, including the addition of Mariposa, the climbing structure butterfly at Berkeley Park. A community garden and multi-purpose trail at Armitos Park, splash pad and other improvements at Johnny D. Wallace Park, and a master plan of Stowe Grove Park are in the works. Stowe Grove redwoods are healthy once again. New irrigation systems and improved tree care have brought back this historic grove of trees. And the park's 15 acre of turf are open to the community for active recreation. This is also a wonderful place to reserve a group picnic area for your next event. Plans have begun for a Lake Los Caneros master plan that will call for a removal of historic but the unsafe footbridge and design for its replacement. The city recently completed an inventory for the Elwood Mesa Monarch Butterfly Habitat Enhancement Project. And butterflies are slowly returning at Elwood Mesa, but there is more work to be done. Assuming Coastal Commission approval, we hope to start work this spring to bring more butterflies back, protect the community from wildfires, and improve our connections to nature. And finally, we have continued work on some of our most challenging issues that require regional and statewide cooperation and coordination, especially the high cost of housing and homelessness. The city is doing everything we can to promote more housing that is affordable. Our affordable housing implementation program is fully staffed and up and running. We are following guidelines from our homeless strategic plan and are partnering with CityNet for outreach and bridge housing for individuals experiencing homelessness. We have partnered with the county to seek funding for 60 apartments for individuals experiencing homelessness in our community, along with on-site managed and supportive services. We have increased coordination with Caltrans on encampment cleanup along Highway 101. And we have increased our ongoing cleanup of abandoned encampments on public lands, and our vegetation management is in order to help protect our community from devastating wildfires. Through all these accomplishments, we've been able to pay our bills while staying within our financial resources. Michelle Green will provide more details on this in just a few minutes. As I suggested earlier, it's not enough for the state of our city to be strong today. It must be strong in preparing for the future. When you think about it, much of our city's infrastructure and processes are rooted in the 20th century. While we are thankful for the public buildings, transportation infrastructure and parks we inherited from that last century, we are working hard to move them into the 21st century. As the sage poets of Fleetwood Mac said, Don't stop thinking about tomorrow. Don't stop, because it'll soon be here. The three examples of planning for the future I alluded to earlier are great illustrations of how we are positioning the Goleta we founded just 20 years ago for the 21st century. Excuse me. First, our beloved Old Town Community Center was built 95 years ago in 1927 as an elementary school. It was upgraded and converted to a community center in 1977. But much of the bones of the structure remain as they were at the dawn of the 20th century. To be a true center for a community to meet, learn, and play, it needs seismic and ADA upgrades. It needs to be properly updated and wired for items such as internet and a modern sound system. We are so forever so grateful for Congressman Carbajal's efforts to secure $3 million in federal money for this capital project. But we are still pursuing, he deserves a hand. But we are still pursuing funding for the estimated $8 million of renovations. We are developing a strategic plan to ensure our community center remains an important gathering spot for this 21st century. In the meantime, we are pleased that the senior center is open again, and also that a 21st century innovation coming to Goleta, pickleball courts, is making its way to the community center. Second, much of our transportation system was founded in the 19th century cow paths and redesigned in the 20th century. Now it needs upgrading for our increased population, vastly increased and changing circulation needs. And our alternative transportation systems, notably sidewalks, crosswalks, and bike lanes, need to be expanded and integrated to provide the safety and convenience we expect in our modern times. Many of our roadways and sidewalks need costly repairs. And to be candid, we don't have the funding to do this all at once. We have an extensive repair program underway. Right now, we're in the process, I'm sure you've seen some of the work, right now we're in the process of making over $6 million in much needed repairs to priority roadway segments, including portions of Cathedral Oaks Road, Hollister Avenue, and Glen Annie Road. Up next, look for construction of the Equal Fowler Street Extension and Hollister Avenue Bridge. At the same time, we are vigorously competing for increased funding locally, statewide, and from the federal government. Recognizing the 21st century's electric vehicle landscape, Goleta has deployed the first EV charging station of its kind in the county, and has plans to add a second charging station at City Hall, and eventually one at Goleta Community Center. Our council will be considering adding more. These will join the growing number of charging stations throughout Goleta to help people who are driving or considering electric vehicles. But a 21st century transportation plan must increasingly include greater and safer opportunities for biking and walking. And we're proud to say we have improved pedestrian and bicycle commuting opportunities and safety with more to come. For pedestrians, we have installed flashing beacon-powered crosswalks at three locations along Cathedral Oaks to improve safe routes to schools. And installed flashing crosswalks at six additional locations throughout the city, with more scheduled. We're also working on vastly improving safety convenience for bike riders. We have completed Goleta's bike master plan to link up with bikeways throughout the South Coast. We are in the process of temporarily restriping Hollister Avenue to provide safe bike lanes through Old Town, while the permanent redesign is being completed. We are finalizing plans and funding for the much anticipated San Jose Bike Path Project. and we're making a major upgrade for train riders and commuters. The Goleta Train Depot project is chugging along through the design and environmental impact process and will become a central hub for fast, safe, and inter- and intra-city commuting. And the third project positioning us for the 21st century is dubbed Broadband for All. The COVID-19 pandemic really highlighted that many individuals and businesses don't have access to fast, reliable, or affordable internet. We are now part of a countywide effort to change that. Much like a utility, that's how it would look. Done correctly, it will bring higher quality, high speed, reliable internet access to everyone at much more affordable rates. This will help not only students and individuals, but also our businesses, startups, and even local government to become more effective and productive. You can help by going to the SBCAG website to take a 1-minute survey and speed test by May 31st. This information, it's important, will be used to show areas where there is poor coverage and improve affordable access to high-speed internet in our homes, schools, businesses, and libraries. And that, my fellow Goletans, is just the beginning. So many of us were born and grew up in the 20th century. It provided a great foundation for education, infrastructure, and political formation. But just as the 1927 risk takers so boldly invested $100,000, $1.5 million in today's money, in that little schoolhouse that is now our community center, we are boldly planning for our next 20 years and beyond. As I have illustrated with just 3 examples, the state of our city is strong because while we work on today's challenges, and there many remain, at the same time we're pursuing key initiatives to keep the state of Goleta's future strong. Thank you all for being here tonight. Thank you so much. Good to see you.